We've got a guest star appearing in our video today. Deion Prime Sanders is here in the flesh.
Prime Sanders.
Doing a show.
I saw a comment that's like, oh man, I'm really liking the dub, except for Ed and Al. And I was like, that's exactly how I feel.
Yeah, the dub is solid, man.
The dub is good.
The dub is solid.
Our favorite war hero, Roy Mustang, or war criminal, or Roy Mustang.
He's a criminal?
He's a criminal?
He's a criminal?
He's not a criminal. I don't know. He's just a state alchemist. I don't know. He decimated that place.
Can I not pause this?
What place?
We don't know exactly.
He's kind of just a merc.
Ishvalon.
Apparently, Jonathan Taylor.
Do you know who Roy Mustang is?
Yes, he decimated that place.
Hey, McKay, do you hear what this guy's saying about Roy?
That would mean you could have.
He's saying he's a war criminal.
He is.
How? That means you'd commit war crimes.
Yeah, is he a war criminal?
Like a decent end.
Ishvalon.
No, that makes sense. He's kind of just a war crimes.
He's a war.
He committed genocide.
He's a war hero.
So yeah, he's a war.
I mean, they pretty much tried to kill their whole race.
That's like saying like Oppenheimer's a war criminal. But he was just hired.
Cannon, right?
Think about it. Be more like what that,
dude, Hitler
tried to eliminate all the Jews. Roy tried to eliminate all the Ishvalons.
Remember on the graph, it showed them in red when they were fighting?
I guess you're right. Like, if you're Ishvalon, Roy is a war criminal. If you're a state alchemist, like, Roy's
like
just
Roy's
a state
should
alchemist.
Should Roy just have let... Ishvalon?
I think it's just a
what were the Ishvalons doing? They were just spreading. Okay, so they weren't killing anybody.
No, they were conquering.
They were just telling
area.
People
they
their ideas.
They were conquering peacefully by killing.
Okay, let's just watch it.
How about?
Yeah, go back.
They were spreading.
Go back.
Even after they were annexed into the country.
They were annexed.
Then, 13 years ago, a military officer accidentally shot and killed an Ishvalon child. And that led to a full-blown civil war.
Comment down below if Roy is a war criminal.
It is
criminal.
A good discussion.
He's not a war criminal, but he's not, like, innocent.
Look, I still like Roy. I'm not saying I don't, but he is a war criminal.
It's actually kind of complicated.
This is kind of complicated.
No,
well,
like, this gets complicated. This
let's find out in the next episode.
It's kind of juicy.
Full Metal Alchemist. I'm gonna start yelling when I talk so people can hear me.
Yeah!
I'm talk like this. Do you guys want to hear me talk like this? Just, like, really loud.
Dude, that's like normal speech. That's literally how loud I'm talking right now.
Girl to get his arm with
her. The man who was responsible for killing a string of state alchemists came after Edward.
That guy gave Edward the word.
Was ready to accept death at Scar's hand.
Yeah, I was going to say, Armstrong really.
The joy of being alive, once again determined to survive and move forward.
I'm from Rizville.
That place is down by the Ishvalon.
Great, but would you mind telling me what the Major's doing here?
For protection.
He's always
what would happen if Scar came after you again? Children can be so stubborn.
Hey, shut up, my new child!
Oh.
I thought he might get lonely without me.
My brother isn't some kind of farm animal!
Oh, right,
it's time.
I'd be impressed by the scenery if I hadn't seen Vinland Saga. Oh.
Where's the Peppa Pig house?
Dr. Marco! Alex Luis on
he's gonna book it.
He was researching into possible medical applications of alchemy.
A guy like this doctor might know some useful things about bioalchemy.
Kind of a juicy place.
Yeah, it's kind of sick. It's kind of like
excuse
Greece.
Me. But do you know who this person is?
Wow, what a good drawing.
Oh, Major, you can really draw.
All of our town's doctors were drafted to help on the battlefields during the Civil War. Then Dr. Morrow came here. He's really been a lifesaver.
You see this big bright flash of light and then you're cured just like that.
Well, I was going to say, this guy's kind of a jeep.
Oh my gosh.
Anything but that. That's not it. Please listen. So you're here to silence me then.
Oh my gosh.
If the rumors I've heard can be believed, when you disappeared, you took top secret materials with you. It took so many lives. During the Civil War, so many innocent died because of it.
See, he's Oppenheimer.
That's crazy because
so
dude opened fire on
just
a person outside the store.
Of taking
like
the Philosopher's Stone. top secret materials I took were my research documents.
You burned him.
No, he just pulls one out.
Oh, it's a liquid.
Imagine it's another Glock.
It's a stone. It's a liquid.
Oh, what the heck?
Just as the Philosopher's Stone is called by many names, so it can take on many forms. There's no way to know when it will reach its limit and become unusable.
Wild, bro.
It's just like the stone that false priest had in Lior. It was incomplete, but it still amplified his powers considerably. Please, Dr. Marco, I need access to your research materials.
He's only a child. And now a child.
You think I don't know what I've signed up for?
This guy's been in his hometown like this whole time. I know.
That's so
you
wild.
You committed the taboo.
Okay,
the
good.
The ability to transmute a specific person's soul.
I was like, why is Ed not telling
you
what happened?
Anyone as talented as you would be able to produce a complete philosopher's stone.
Not even if it's to get our bodies back?
Never! This is the devil's research. Please.
You tell him, Ed.
Please just leave.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a power. It's like too powerful for, like, to just willingly let somebody do.
It's kind of like how Harry broke the Elder One. Bro, but if I'm Ed, I'm storming that place.
No, the main character always got that talk jutsu, bro. They always reach people's souls with their words.
Could be useful. You could have taken it from the doctor by force.
We don't want it so badly that we'd be willing to deprive this town of their only doctor to get it.
They have good attitudes on them.
What about you, Major?
Is that a question mark on the back of his cloak?
Dr. Marco's location.
Oh!
The comeback.
Told you.
Dr. Marco?
Don't tell
this
me.
This is where my materials are. Look closely. Maybe you'll find the truth hidden within the truth.
W doctor.
Wow.
You.
Finding one book in that giant library will be difficult indeed.
I mean, that's the best.
Another clue about the stone.
Yeah, that's the best tip they've gotten in their whole life.
Oh no.
Like, is homie dead?
I've been looking for.
Oh no.
Dude,
how'd she find him?
I bet she's tailing.
Why can't we find her?
Dang, that's a grind.
Yo, Greg!
That is a grind.
Is this his love interest?
A lot has happened. Can you fix us up? I know I haven't seen you for a while, Ed. But you've gone and grown smaller. I'm still taller than you, you mini hag!
He didn't even say anything, dude.
All you ever do is worry me.
In order to get this information,
he's the Full Metal Alchemist dog.
That's so cool.
Am I right? Leg aside, shape the arms in. We'll have to build it from scratch.
Don't tell me she was trying to make his leg go.
Done in a week. We'll be finished before you get used to it.
3 days, huh? Well, you want to get to Central as soon as possible, right? Then I'll work my butt off for you.
Imagine chopping wood with your fist.
I haven't seen Edward anywhere around the house in a while.
That is actually so cool. They need that pup to join them.
Ed and Al are well known for their alchemy, even in a high-profile place like Central. Sometimes that gets them into trouble.
He's the boss, baby.
A strong boy.
Yeah, he's got that little hair on his
strong,
head.
Huh?
Strange.
I'm a friend of the family, you see. The boy's father is an old drinking pal of mine. One day, he up and left the village, abandoning his wife and sons.
Oh, he's trapped underground.
The freaking eternal.
His face
is
gone, Major. They both died in the Civil War. There were never enough doctors for all the injured soldiers. You look like you could eat a lot, but don't worry, there's plenty. We also have an empty patient's cot and some spare bedding.
She's tiny.
The boys don't have anywhere else to stay but here. It's gone now. The brothers don't have any home to return to.
What?
They burned down their own house.
Dang.
My guess is they did it because with no house to come home to, there could be no turning back.
They burned the boats, literally.
That's crazy.
This is a cool scene, dude.
I'm back.
Oh, Edward Elric! What determination to burn down your own house! awaits you. There is no retreat. Come, Edward. Allow me to help you in this comforting embrace.
Always taking the shirt.
Don't want your chest on me.
Jeez.
Poor Edward.
Man, she is working her butt off.
Look at you working hard so early in the morning.
Been up all night.
I mean, that's like 72 hours straight.
Power of Adderall.
Do you think she's giving him the Mark 42?
Get out!
Yeah, I know. It's just when I think of a clue to the stone sitting in Central Library somewhere, I get so impatient. Yeah, on one, two, three. That's the worst part every time when the nerves have to connect like that. Oh. Our biggest source of income. I'll be sad to see you go.
What a good attitude for working for like 3 days straight.
So epic.
That was crazy. He was like doing the splits on the wall.
Put his leg up. Hey, listen up!
Major, you see that seal on the inside of his back? That's the medium between Al's soul and the armor.
Wow.
There you go. You're good as new.
Easy.
You're ready to try it out?
You get to do that with Watermill.
Time to head to Central and find Dr. Marco's documents. We need first
duo.
Thing tomorrow morning.
And so, now, good duo.
Al can do alchemy, right? No?
Yeah. Wait. I think he did. I don't. There was one instance where he might have used it.
Or is he just a... Is he just a...
It's like, I'm gonna out again.
I don't think he feels anything. I don't think he eats anything. I don't think he sleeps.
And brother's 15.
What's this? Why so formal?
Granny, Winry, I'm so grateful to you for always welcoming us like we're really family. He won't ever say it, but I know brother feels the same way.
Yeah, Al is kind of like the older brother. Why does he have to wear that backwards apron?
Want me to wake her? That's okay. She just nagged me. Make sure to do your maintenance or whatever. You want us to come all this way into the mountains just for some dinner?
Come back soon, okay?
She looks like that chick who's like Roy's assistant.
Yeah, why did I feel like there was a little something?
I love when a main character, like, you can tell that they have, like, feelings for someone and they, like, really care about them, but, like, they're so dedicated to their goal.
They're coy. Like,
they always stay focused.
Yeah,
like,
right.
He's like, should I wake her? And he's like, Nah, time. That's not. He's not being like a tool. He's just like,
yeah. Well, because then she comes out and he's just like,
and he's like,
yeah.
But she's like, he's so like dedicated to his goal.
No, that one was just like, I can't.
That was like a slice of life episode.
Well, the Philosopher's Stone.
Except for the Philosopher's Stone, that was sick, dude.
And darn it, Tim is about to get piped.
Yeah, it's like this little
like it has different forms.
Tim is about to get wrecked.
Kind of makes sense when you think of the Philosopher's Stone. People want to like.
Well, who knows what it's going to look like when it's complete? Because isn't that an incomplete version?
Really? Yeah.
Like, maybe the completed one is an actual.
Do you have to do you have to create a Philosopher's Stone, or do you find it?
I think you have to create one.
Oh, let me just spoil the whole show.
Hey.
How the guy had to create the Philosopher's Stone. The Nicholas Flamel guy created the Philosopher's Stone.
So you have to make it then.
Nicholas Flamel? From Harry Potter?
The whole plot, if I told you.
Remember how he created a Philosopher's Stone? Like he made
I thought he found that thing.
No, he made it. He's the only one ever who
ever he made it.
Yeah, Nicholas Flamel's him.
All we've seen are incomplete ones. Right?
So it's like,
yeah. That's the interesting
wasn't
thing.
Wasn't he like
dude.
So old, dude? He's like 600
like,
years
brutal.
Old.
I mean, that's the best news he could have ever received in his life. Imagine you're like whole life is like bent on this one thing and you like literally don't know where to look and then I'm like
true.
Okay like
you
it's in the library it's in the public
no,
library over there.
It would
there.
Be like if I was like hey I know that guy walking down the street and then he tells you where it is.
Yeah,
like I can't believe Major Armstrong just knew him.
Well, that's what I'm saying. He's just they're going on the train to like go to Granny's and the guy's like hey that's this famous doctor that has secret information from the war regarding your only goal in life.
He's
let's
like,
go talk to him.
He's like the definition of hiding in plain sight, almost. Like, you just never would have found him.
It was
he's,
weird how, like, he could heal people, though, perfectly, but he couldn't have healed Edward to some extent.
He was like Bruce Banner when in Avengers 1 when he's just off in that country.
Oh,
he's
yeah,
India?
Like India.
Yeah, helping them.
And Black Widow raises him up.
let me make sure I get this correctly. Let me make sure I get this correct. So, no. The reason why they lost their bodies is because they did the taboo, right? Mm-hmm. And what we understand up until this point is that, like, you cannot, like, sacrifice, like, because it's always comes down to the law of equivalent exchange, but you can't sacrifice for somebody that's died.
Well, it's just because there's no, they don't know what,
like, you can't bring someone back to life.
They don't know what the worth of a soul is, and yeah, they're trying to bring a soul back, and so, like, you can't.
Yeah, like the equivalent exchange of a soul.
My only thing is, like, could they use a soul to make a soul? Doing good. Could they use a soul to make a soul? Could they sacrifice somebody else to bring back somebody else?
He kind of did with his brother.
Well, he sacrificed a part of him to bring back a part of him.
No, they just tried to create a human.
He only
he partially succeeded because he brought back his brother's soul. And remember when he found the it thing, he, like, learned the truth.
He,
like,
tied his brother's soul to the armor.
Yeah, but, like, he succeeded in, like,
doing
something.
But he had to make a sacrifice.
He brought his soul back.
His arm to get that.
Yeah, so...
I think he knows something that we don't know, because he learned so much when he was in that, like, thing, learning everything or shoving all the information in his mind. He knows things that he hasn't said yet.
Yeah, it's weird because there's, like, there's the mom who's completely dead, and then there's the two brothers, and in the pursuit of the mom, they lost one of the brothers all the way, but then he bound his soul to the armor. So, like, it's weird. It's like Al is kind of like the weird in between from the mom and Ed, you know? So I'm, like, wondering, like, what is a Philosopher's Stone gonna do to break the taboo, you know?
Well, I think
also,
it just negates
the equivalent exchange.
Also, it seems like that Ed, like, all we've seen is, like, oh, maybe you can do it because, like, he's, like, such a prodigy. That's why, like, Ed was, like, to Al, he's like, did you see it? And he's like, what? Because, like, I think Ed is, like, such a high level, like, talent that, like, he has the ability to, like, go off and, like, to whatever that guy, like...
I forgot what his name was.
I don't know. But do you know what I mean? Because, like, Al lost everything and didn't even, like, see that place. Yeah. But then, like, Ed didn't like, die, and he, like, went into this place, and the guy was like, I'll show you.
Not Tim.
So it's, like, it's almost like he has, like, a different access to the alchemy, like...
Yeah.
Like, world, because he's just, like, such a prodigy.
Is elevated.
So, I don't know.
So interesting, dude. So many mysteries.
It's, like, almost as good as Hunter x Hunter. It's crazy.
So many mysteries. I want to know them all. I want
That's
to know
it.
Them.
It's
impossible! They do a great job of explaining it, though, over time.
Yeah. I love how this show isn't, like, one thing I really like about the show is it's not, it's not confusing. It's complex. Like, and I think there's a very big distinction between the two. Like, I love Jujutsu Kaisen, but sometimes it's just, like, a little confusing, you know, like I feel
the
like
they
don't
kind of lay it out.
They don't they don't explain things in the greatest ways. This show is just complex, where it's like they could be looked at as kind of a similar thing, but, like, it's not. Like, this show is just, like, so deep that, like, you have to really follow along. And I really like that about this show so far.
People actually think you read it.
Who?
Brig.
Why?
In what? Here on this?
Yes.
Why?
Because you guessed the chimera thing.
What did I guess again?
That he was going to use his daughter and the dog.
Nina?
I am
so sad. I don't know. It's kind of like when you knew it was the wife, you're like, dude, he's going to do something.
Who's worse, that guy or Ymir?
That guy. What was his name again?
I don't know.
Tucker.
Tucker.
Oh,
yes.
Dr. Tucker.
I like really
show.
Like,
just gets brought up so frequently.
Briggs Ymir is my Becca.
Okay, wow. She is
Becca.
Not on that level.
Bro,
Becca.
She pisses me off.
That's crazy.
Wait,
actually.
Who's
the little chick with
from Cyberpunk?
I know, but, like,
she's the one that she's like David. She's like, she, like, really likes David, but David's not into her.
She's
like little,
kid.
And
she's
always yelling.
She's
about stuff.
Girl.
Yes.
She's so annoying,
but she's, like,
she's
the
annoying,
same age
baby.
As him,
no,
but...
Like,
it's, like, true, though.
She's so true. That's crazy to put her on Ymir level.
What?
That's so
dude,
crazy. one of the hottest takes of the year.
They like hard.
Dude, I didn't say she's on Ymir's level. I just said Briggs Ymir is my Becca.
Like, her. The camera was just saying, like,
I'm just saying, like, for me, like, it's crazy because people literally like Becca more than Lucy. And, like, I can't fathom that.